Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to PE with Miss McGill. Now, this doesn't exactly look like me, but it'll do for now. Now, I've decided to call you guys exercisers, because let's face it, when you're with me, you are exercisers. You're exercising your body and your mind.
Get ready for week 9 because it's going to be a very fun, exciting, and interesting week of learning. So come and join me with anybody that you'd like in your family, in your house,
even Grandpa.
Previous teaching point.
Previous teaching point. You know, what we learned last week.
The difference between a muscle and a joint. And selecting an appropriate stretch for a particular activity.
Connection. Now that we know how to select appropriate stretches for particular activities, we're going to be much more prepared to move and exercise. But have you ever thought about how we can do this? How are we able to exercise? This week, I'm going to teach you about how our body is able to do that.
Our current group goal is
learning
the relationship between the heart, blood, muscles, lungs, and oxygen during physical activity and how to roll a ball for accuracy towards a target. Teaching point.
This week, before we warm up our bodies, we're going to exercise our minds.
Exercisers, today I want to teach you about how we're able to exercise through the relationship between the heart, lungs, muscles, blood, and oxygen during physical activity.
First, we breathe in oxygen, also known as air, through our nose and mouth. Say oxygen with me 3 times. Ready, go. Oxygen, oxygen, oxygen. Second, lungs bring oxygen into the body. Say lungs with me 3 times. Ready, go. Lungs, lungs, lungs. Third, the heart pumps the blood. Say heart with me 3 times. Ready, go. Heart, heart, heart.
Step 4. Oxygen sticks to red blood cells. Say blood with me 3 times. Ready, go. Blood, blood, blood. Step 5. Blood transports oxygen to your muscles using blood vessels. Say muscles with me 3 times. Ready, go. Muscles, muscles, muscles. Now it's time to stand up and warm up our muscles. Thank you.
To begin, select a target that's large.
That's gonna be in the way. Much better.
So here's my first large target. There are four parts to rolling a ball towards a target.
Number one, body facing the target. Number two, feet shoulder width apart. I need to switch up the ball. Number three, step back, step roll. Step back, step roll. Number four, keep your arm in line with the target.
Let's practice step back together 5 times. Ready? Go. Step back. Step back, step back, step back, step back. Now let's practice step back, step roll together 5 times. Ready? Go. Step back, step roll, step back, step roll, step back, step roll, step back, step roll, step back, step roll.
Next, I'd like to give you 5 minutes to step roll, step back, step roll, step back at a target somewhere in your house. If you don't have a ball to roll, you can roll an imaginary ball. You can also create a sock ball by rolling 2 pairs of socks into a ball. Ready? Begin.